Hey, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kara. I'm a new beauty content creator who just loves playing with makeup. So as most of you probably know, Natasha Denona had just recently came out with her new mini Biba palette as well as her rose cheek duo. I got them both. I just had to pick them up, of course. So for today's video, we're gonna be using the products and seeing how they perform. So the first product I'm going to talk about is the Rose Cheek Duo. Here is the packaging that the product comes in. Here is the actual packaging. It is quite small, and as you can see, it is a mirroring effect, which I personally don't like those because they get dirty very quickly. As you can see, they're all fingerprinted and they don't photograph very well either. So here is the inside. This is her cream blush and highlighter. The cream blush is considered a warm rose, and then the highlighter, it's her super glow highlighting powder, and these have a 18-month shelf life. They're made in Italy and they go for $19. This is my first cheek duo of Natasha that I own, so I can't necessarily compare this to her other palettes for you, unfortunately. So right off the bat, it does feel, the blush feels very creamy. And the highlighter feels very, very smooth and silky. So here is the blush and the highlighter. I'm going to apply the blush with a sponge on one side and with a brush on the other to see if there's any differences. So I'm first going to apply the blush with a brush, and I'm using a BK Beauty 106 brush. I'm just gonna dab right in there. Now it looks like it does apply very lightly. So I'll probably have to go in again. So I did dip into the pan one more time. And this color is gonna go really good with the palette. So using a brush, it seems to apply very nicely. Let's try going in with a sponge and see if there's any difference. So I'm gonna take my sponge and I'm just gonna dab it in there. So on first application, it went on pretty nicely. It didn't go on bad at all. And it actually matches the other side quite well. I went in twice with a brush on this side and only once with a sponge. So it looks like using either or should work pretty well. I did not set my face before using the blush, so I don't know if that would make a difference or not, putting the blush over top of powder. So let's go into the highlighter. I'm using a Real Techniques 402 brush, just a little tiny brush. And I'm just gonna go in. Now what's really nice about this is it's not overpowering. As you can probably see, let me get a little closer. It's not overpowering at all, which is something that I like. I like a somewhat subtle highlighter, but that gives you a little bit more than subtle, if that makes any sense. So we're gonna put some on the other side. I'm going back into the highlighter. That is gorgeous. And apparently, the blush and highlighter are two new colors. She does not have these shades out anywhere else. So now let's move on to the palette. Natasha Denona came out with her mini Biba palette. I do not own the full-size Biba palette. That's why I had to get this. I had to try it. I will say, this is my first palette that's an extension of a bigger palette. I have a couple of her 5 PM palettes that aren't considered extensions on her bigger palettes. So when I got this in the mail, I was really surprised on how small it was. Her other palettes that are not extensions are like this size right here. And I'll show you. So this palette isn't an extension of a bigger palette. And here's the Mini Viva. Like, I was just really surprised of how small it was. So here is the box that the palette comes in. It's her typical box. Here is the back that has the ingredients and the shade and shade names. Here is the palette itself. As you can see, it's already dirty. I had already used it, but it's her usual packaging. It has the acrylic top, and on the back, which you probably can't see very well, but it has each of the shade names and the type of formula they are. And then here are the shades. And apparently these shades also are all new shades. So you have three creamy matte shades, which is this one, and this one. You have her cream to powder, and then you have her metallic shade. So I'm gonna swatch these for you. So first shade we have is Bruno, which is a creamy matte. It's considered a deep mahogany brown. Then you have Izzy, which is a creamy matte, and it's considered a nude dusty rose. Then we have Blaze Nude, which is a metallic, and it's a light rosy nude. Here's what they look like on the fingers. And then swatching them. Ooh. So that first shade, Bruno, didn't swatch very well at all. And please don't mind my nails. I'm getting them done today. Then we have Plush, which is a creamy matte, which is considered a light medium dusty coral. And then Wink, which is her cream to powder, and it's considered a medium dusty coral brown. They look like on the fingers. The creamy matte swatched pretty well. Here are all the swatches. So the palette goes for $25. It's made in Italy and it has a 24-month shelf life. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go do one eye off camera. I'll come back and we'll do the other eye together. Right, so I did the one eye. So let's get into the tutorial and finish this look together. So I'm first gonna go into Izzy with a Sigma E25. And I'm gonna put that just in the inner part of my crease. Now I'm going into Izzy with the same brush, and I'm gonna put that in the middle of my crease. Now I'm gonna take another clean Sigma E25 and go into Wink, and that's gonna go on the outer part of my crease. Go into Bruno with a Sigma E49, and I'm going to put that on my outer lid and up into my crease. And remember, this is the shade that swatched poorly, but it definitely seems to blend out very well as long as you don't go in with a ton of product at once. Going back into Plush with a Sigma E40. I'm going to use that to just blend over everything on top. I'm going to go into Izzy with a pencil brush. I'm going to put that along my entire lower lash line. I'm also going to take the shade Bruno with the same brush, and that's going to go on my lower lash line, also just in the outer corner. I'm going to take a Sigma E54 and go into Blaze Nude. I'm going to put that on my lid where there is no shadow. And I am putting that above, like in my crease as well, because I have hooded eyes, so it'll peek through and make my eyes look bigger. Back to my Sigma E25 with no product, just to gently blend over top of that shimmer. take a Sigma LO4 brush and I'm gonna go into the highlight into the Rouge Cheek Duo, and I'm gonna use that for my inner corner highlight. All right, now I'm gonna go do liner and lashes, and I'll be right back to show you the final look and give you my thoughts about the palette and cheek duo. All right, I'm back, and here's your finished look. So my thoughts about the palettes. I like the palettes, they're cute. I'm not sure how her formula is for the creamy blush. I don't know if it's gonna dry out fast. I'm not sure. I guess only time will tell. The highlighter, I really like the highlighter. I mean, I like a bling, but I don't like something like blinding. And this is very beautiful. The palette's pretty. There's not many looks that you're gonna be able to probably come up with. When it comes to this, you could probably get maybe 3 looks out of this. Maybe, I mean, I don't know. I would have to play with it. But it's not bad, $25, especially I think the Biba palette's like $129. So if you wanna try out Natasha Denona's formula, these $25 palettes are the best way to go, even though if you really do the calculations with the grams, the bigger palettes are actually a better value than these. But I get $25 over $129. That's a big difference. But this is a really nice palette. I absolutely recommend this. I recommend the blush and highlight duo as well, and that's only $19. But again, I don't know about her formula and if the blush is gonna dry out. So thank you guys so much for watching my video today. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. I will link everything down in the description box below. I hope everybody has a great holiday and a great Christmas coming up. Be safe, and I hope to see you all again soon.